It's 2050 and the meeting has crashed. Water levels are rising because of global warming.
It is a view of our world. Our design includes two yellow legs or pillars so that part of our world could still be built above sea level.
Our tour will begin inside one of the legs at the education centre. On our way, we will pass through the forest and where we grow trees out of direct sunlight, which is now just too hot.
At the school, students will still learn about maths and English, but the main focus is on environmental sustainability and agriculture. Rural animals are cared for here, and a captive breeding program for endangered animals ensures that they survive for generations to come.
As we leave the school, there are transparent hallways where students can explore local marine life and learn how to care for their underwater ecosystems, such as sea turtles.
Here is the science lab. At the moment, our world is partially underwater and some of the population is living in submarines-like conditions.
However, like a submarine, they cannot live there forever. So the experts are busy trying to develop a method to live underwater for a more permanent and extended period of time. All over the city, you will find waste pits where leftover food and rubbish is broken down and used as compost for growing plants and farming. Nothing goes to waste. It's really quick and easy to move around our city as we have built passageways to join each section to minimize traffic. Here is our farm where we grow wheat and vegetables as our world encourages healthy eating. We've introduced bees to transfer pollen and help the plants grow. Other rooms include a library with enchanted books and a music box, an armor room which has supplies in case of an invasion, a cafeteria where we serve a locally produced and fresh food.
The last stop on our tour is the rooftop. It has a rainbow beacon which acts like a lighthouse. It emits light, preventing ships from crashing into the town. Solar panels and a wind turbine are located here, which are the town's main power source. Animals are scheduled to live on the rooftop to different times of the year, like the foxes are now, so that they can be exposed to a more natural light, which they are genetically accustomed to.
Hello, I'm Caleb. I am the project manager and doer.
Hello, I'm Skinner. I'm the designer and video person.
Hello, I'm Bronx. I'm the planner.
Hi, my name's Bailey. I was the co-builder.
Thanks for watching.